One of the beauties of being single is the opportunity to learn about yourself, befriend with yourself, and discover everything bright and beautiful about who you are and prepare yourself for your future spouse. However, the days of being single and the time in waiting isn't always very easy, and it is not without its own challenges and tests and temptations and trials. Life, they say, is in phases, and men, they come in sizes. And so, to every man is his own size of tests and trials. However, there are some tests that pertains to all men, and there are ways in which all men are tested and tried in the same way. Most notably are the sexual tests and temptations and trials that comes to all young men and women who are at the phase of waiting. Even the most spiritual men will be tested in the same way, for the Bible says we are all men of like passions. So what do you do when you are single but your body desires sex so much? How can you overcome? How do you win? How do you cope with sexual desires, passions, longings when your body wants so much to have sex? Is the word of God filled with truths that can guide us through such moments? Can a believer find out and know how he can be equipped for such moments? Have there been moments in the past where you were overcame by these trials and temptations? Have you caved into sin? Have you found yourself doing something you ought not to have been doing? Have you found yourself satisfying and meeting your sexual needs in ways that are not proper? Have you found yourself indulging in activities to satisfy your sexual urge? Is there a word from God about this? There's a whole lot God has to say, and we can learn from the examples of the fathers. For every one of them were men of like passions, and they were tempted in every way just as we were, including most notably Jesus. There are a few things you can do. First and foremost, always think, what would Jesus do? Every time you find yourself in a sexually tensed state, when that time of the month, or that time of the week, that time of the day comes, and you see yourself longing for a sexual satisfaction that you know you cannot yet satisfy because either your marriage partner is not within your reach, or just because you are not married and you ought not to be doing any such thing now, just ask yourself, what would Jesus do if Jesus were in my shoes? What would Jesus do when Jesus was in my shoes? Because he feels what we feel. What is Jesus going to do now? The Bible says Jesus was tempted in every way, just as we were and that we are, but yet without sin. How did Jesus do it? He did it by the grace of God and by the help of the Holy Spirit and by the knowledge of the Word. What does this mean? It means you can engage the Spirit, the Word, and the grace to help you in time of need. So the Bible says in the book of Hebrews, the 4th chapter, it says to come boldly to the throne of grace in time of need. Very important, because sometimes people think when they're already in need, they can no longer seek help. When you're already so pressed to satisfy your sexual urge, a lot of people's minds are blocked and they do not think right, and they think they can no longer do anything unless they get satisfied or satisfy themselves and their passions. But that's not true. You can do something. You can still make the right choice. It may be difficult at the beginning, but as you keep doing it consistently, you suddenly realize you do have the willpower to do the right thing. You have what it takes to choose life over death. You have what it takes to act exactly like Jesus. You have what it takes to surrender your sexual passions and desire to the Master's feet. You can give it all to him and leave it there. You know, Jesus Christ doesn't want you coming to him only when everything is fine, but even more so in that temptation, in the valley of the shadow of death, he still wants to be with you. When you feel the pressure so much, and you hear voices, and you have feelings in your bodies, and you feel aroused, and you feel so tensed, and you feel like you should do something, call someone, meet someone, go somewhere, you can rest on Jesus. Always remember, the Bible says to look to Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Jesus doesn't just want to be the author of your faith, he wants to be the finisher. And he doesn't just want you to want to be the finisher, he wants to be the author. So every time you're trying to step out in faith, and therefore by grace, act like Jesus. Choose to act like Jesus. The second thing you want to do is to remember that where you are now, someone else has been. The Bible says there's no such temptation as is uncommon with men, but all temptations are the type that is common with men. It says God also makes a way of escape. Remember, there are several examples of men of God who were tempted sexually, who had desires, who were men of like passion. I'll give two quick examples. The first one we want to look at is the life and the story of Joseph and Mary. Joseph was a man of like passion, and he found himself a woman that he liked so much, who was engaged to him, that he wanted to marry, and they were ready to marry. And if you've ever been married before, and think even without being married, you'd know that when there is someone that you already can see who can satisfy you sexually, as created and ordained by God, your whole system, body and mind, begins to prepare itself for that. And so Joseph was in a stage where he was preparing himself, and Mary also were preparing themselves for their marriage, which was soon to be, before suddenly, unplanned, an angel shows up and completely changes their plans. Before you know it, Mary, who had kept herself all this while as a virgin, which is to say, they had no previous contact, himself and Joseph. And of course, that meant they had the only opportunity was they were looking to marriage to do that. But then suddenly, now, by reason of the ministry of the angel and the Holy Spirit's work on the life of Mary, Mary gets pregnant. And the Bible goes on to show us in that scripture that Joseph never had sexual intercourse with his wife until after the delivery of the child, Jesus. But he took her in as a wife. Can you imagine what it must have felt like to have the wife in your house? But you're unable, both of you, live in the same house. He watched her take her bath. He was there in her life. They lived in the same room, slept on the same bed, but he never crossed the line. I want you to think upon this very critically and seriously, because the Bible says these things were written for an example for us. So there were men like Joseph who were able to hold themselves. Have you been tempted in the same way? Or are you just there? Think about Joseph. How was he able to do it? Because God wants you to learn that you too can. It is possible for you to stay single and be non-sexual and be non-sexually engaged until the right and the appropriate time. It's possible to abstain from sexual practices that are not yet ordained or permitted of God. It is possible to wait for your spouse. I'm sure it must have been difficult and challenging for Joseph. I'm sure it was not easy because he was a human being. He absolutely had to go through that moment and watch a beautiful woman by his side daily and not be able to involve himself sexually with her. I believe God has kept these scriptures in the Bible for us so that we can learn and so that we can know that we have no excuses and we have no reasons, no matter how sexually needy or starved or desiring that we are. It's my prayer that God will help us, each and every one of us, to continue holding on until the right time, until your spouse shows up, until you get married, and even when they are not around, for you to be able to stay true until they are back in your life. God bless you.